everyone, welcome to my channel. This is going to be my first Halloween video, so I don't want to do much talking. I just want to get right into the look, so let's get started. First thing I'm going to be doing is basically finding out the placements for the horns. These are two horns that I bought at a Halloween store. They were for like $6, so I will place all that information in the description box. But all I'm doing is I'm going to take a brown eyeliner pencil and I'm going to basically draw a circle around the horn where I want it to be placed later on. And this is just going to be used as like a guideline to know that in this area I don't put any makeup, and within these circles is where the horn is going to be placed. Now we're going to get started on the face. I'm going to take my Becca Ever Matte Primer and my Smashbox Photo Finish Primer, and I'm going to mix these two and I'm going to apply this all over my face. I do always do my eyebrows off camera, but in this video I did do my brows a little bit different. They're more in of an upwards angle. Now for foundation, I'm going to take my Anastasia Beverly Hills foundation stick in the color Cocoa. I got this color because my last color that I had was just not my skin color, so this color matches my skin much better. And I'm just gonna place this all around my face and I'm gonna just blend it in with my foundation brush that I always use. Now we're gonna go back and work on the horn area. I'm taking this liquid latex that I got from Ricky's NYC. This is by the brand Ben Nye, and this is liquid latex, and I'm gonna be placing this around the circles that I drew. You do not want to get this product on your hair at all. That is why I just took two pins to move my hair out the way, and I tried to not get too close to my brows, even though I did have to get a little close, but not on my brows at all. You do not want to get this on your hair at all. So if you your hair is in the way, get your hair out the way. Do not put this over eyebrows or anything like that. You would have to cover your eyebrows first. So just get any hair out the way, and I'm just basically laying this down on my skin in like a large area, because you'll see later on we're gonna peel up the insides so that it look like skin. And I'm just gonna do the same thing on the other side, and then I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna go back to my face while it dries. Now I'm going to take my LA Girl Pro Concealer in the color Fawn. I'm going to highlight my face as I would on a regular day. And then I'm going to take my beauty blender and I'm going to blend that out. You guys know my last beauty blender broke because of my little sister, so I did get a new one. This one is black. I thought that was just the perfect color to get for this month, you know, Halloween. But yeah, I'm just going to blend everything out perfectly and nicely. And I did also blend out the concealer over my eyes. Now I'm gonna take my Laura Mercier translucent powder, and I did apply this a little bit differently in this video. I took it on the beauty blender and I basically pressed it into my skin and over my eyes. I did this because I know I'm gonna be working with like a lot of color on the face, so I wanted to make sure that the product really sets into my skin. So I pressed it into my skin first and then I'm gonna go in and bake with it. Now I'm gonna take my MAC skin finish in the color Dark Deep. I've been hearing such great things about this, so I decided to pick it up, and this is actually a really good face powder. Like, I really love it. So I'm just applying it all over my face. And now you see I'm checking to see if the latex has dried, and it has dried. So I'm gonna take the same mineralized skin finish powder and I'm just gonna brush it over the latex to just get rid of some of the shine. But you're not gonna get rid of all of it, but just to get rid of some of the shine, I'm gonna brush it over it. Now I'm gonna peel from the inside out. You do not wanna peel the whole thing off, you just wanna open it up on the inside so that you can push the horn in and it can hold the horn. So I'm using my nails here, but the proper way you can use something to peel it up, as you will see for the next one, I'm gonna use a tweezers to peel it up. Once it's peeled up, this is how it should look. Now for this one, like I said, I did use the tweezers for this one so that you can see how it looks, and it does not hurt at all. And I did try to like rip it up a little bit, the edges, so that it would look like rough, ripped skin. But now I did already put in one horn on one side. Now I'm showing you guys how I put in the other one. I basically use my tweezers to help me stretch the latex out so that I can get the horn inside and just basically work its way inside of the latex, basically. Yeah. And yeah, this is how it looks. The horns are really lightweight. They're like just rubber plastic, so they're really lightweight. There might be some parts of the latex that lift a little bit, so all you got to do is go over it with some more latex and let that dry. So that's what you see me doing right here, is fixing any parts that did lift up a little. Now I'm going to move on to my eyes, and I'm going to take this palette. This is my Shani Cosmetics palette, and I'm going to take this red color, and I'm going to place this like all over my eyes, and I'm going to blend it like outwards and underneath my eyes. We're trying to go for like a messy, smoked out eye look, but like one of those eye looks that you see in the movies when someone is like dead. So we're just gonna go for that whole smoked out eye, red and black eye. Now I'm going to take that same red and I'm going to apply it around the horn area, because when something comes out your skin, obviously you will have bruising and irritation around that area. So we're just going to add some of the red to make that area look irritated. And I'm going to take this contour powder, since it's like a dark brown, and I'm going to place this around the horns also to just darken up the bruising and make it look even more irritated. Now I'm going in with a black, and this is inside my Makeup Geek palette. This color is, I believe, Blackout. But yes, I'm placing this all over my eyes also. I'm not gonna blend it out as much as I did the red, but I'm just gonna blend it out a little bit. And I did go in some more with some of the red to like fix it a little bit. I did have to go back and forth a lot here to get what I wanted. The eye is how you want it. I decided to add some eyeliner. You can't really see the eyeliner, so I really didn't even care if it was perfect, but I'm taking my Ruby Kisses liquid eyeliner and I'm just creating a wing. Now I'm taking some of the brown that I placed around the horns and I'm contouring my nose with it. And I wanted to look like a deep contour because like I semi want to look like really tired and bruised and half dead. So I did make the contour really harsh, and I did put a lot on my cheekbone contour also. And now I'm gonna take some of that black eyeshadow and I'm gonna contour my cheekbones with it too. And I did go in with another brush with nothing on it just to blend this out so it won't look so harsh. I wanted it to look really faded. And then I went in with the same red eyeshadow as like blush. And to just make that contour a little bit more cut, I did go in with some Laura Mercier powder underneath to cut it a little bit more. And for lashes, I picked up these lashes in the store somewhere. I don't even remember, but the lashes, I thought they would have been a little bit more bold because they were really large, but they just didn't come out that way. Now I'm taking my Makeup Forever Pro Sculpting Duo in number 2. I was hearing such great things about this that I decided to pick it up and use it as my highlighter. So that is what I'm using right now. And it's so pretty. I didn't want to use too much because this is kind of like a Halloween look, and I don't want it to be too glam. I want it to look more scary and gory than glam, so I did use a little bit. Now I'm taking a black eyeliner and I'm using that as a lip liner. I didn't want to use brown because I wanted it to be dark. Now I'm taking my Kylie Cosmetics matte liquid lipstick in the color Mary Jo K, and I'm placing this on my lips. Now for the fun part, I'm going to be using Stage Blood that I got from Ben Nye, and I did pick this up at Ricky's NYC also. And I'm taking a sponge here and I'm ripping it apart, and I'm going to be using the rough side to apply the blood. I would have poured the blood into a plate, but I didn't have a plate with me, so I just used this mirror that I had and applied it on top of that. And first I'm taking a brush and I'm applying some of the blood on the insides of the latex that I put around the horns to make it look like blood is coming out of the skin, since the latex is supposed to be mimicking skin. So yeah, as you guys can see, I did the other one already, and I'm doing this one for you guys to see. But I'm just lifting the latex with a tweezer, and I'm using the brush to apply the blood on the inside. And now I'm brushing some blood up on the horns, because if it came out your skin, the horns should not be so clean. So I brushed some blood up on top of it. And as you guys can see, I did the other one again. And now I'm taking the sponge and I'm pressing some blood around the horn, because I want it to look really bloody. I don't know, I just wanted it to be really bloody. So I'm just applying a lot of blood around the horns. Then I just randomly decided to add some blood on my neck. I don't even know why, but I just felt like, let's add blood everywhere, right? It's a Halloween look. Make it bloody. Then I decided to add some blood around my eyes to make it look like I was crying blood. I did cut out like most of the parts where I was directly putting it on my eyes, because I did put some in my eyes by accident and I was making like some really weird faces. So yeah, but be careful when using these near your eyes. What I did was pick up a lot of blood on the brush and then let it drop onto my skin, and then it just flowed down my face. And make sure you have something in your lap when working with this, because this can be really messy and really sticky. Now the look is done. I hope you guys loved it. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and give me some Halloween ideas for other videos that you guys would like to see. But thank you guys for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Mwah!